गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, टुडे आई एम हियर एट नाजिंग बाजार विच इज़ अ पॉपुलर सैटरडे वीकली मार्केट इन टूरा. द लोकल ट्रेडर्स कम हियर एंड सेट अप देयर शॉप्स अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग एंड वाइंड अप इन द इवनिंग. वी डू गेट ऑल द लोकल प्रोड्यूस एज वेल एज ट्रेडर्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टूरा हु कम एंड सेल देयर प्रोड्यूस और यू नो गुड्स. Like, and it starts at almost 6:30 in the morning. However, it's about 9:30 a.m. and I tried to avoid the maximum number of crowd, hence thought of visiting only post 9. However, if you are really interested to get some good deals, do come here and let's see what Nazing Bazaar has to offer and let's head out there and explore the market.
Look at these gooseberries. They're just ripening and the season is here. And this is how the bottle gourd in Northeast India looks like, unlike what we get in South. Those are nolkhol, just so you know. And these are some of my favorite things available. Yeah, these are taro leaves. Abhi, beso khane. Yeah, these are really delicious when cooked with dried fish, which are here. Yeah, these are smoked dried fish. Just look at them. They really smell great and goes well with most of your dishes that we locally prepare here. I'm sure you can see how fresh the vegetables are. And these are the roots of those taro leaves. Yeah, you can eat them by cooking with pork, chicken, fish, whatever you may prefer, or just boiled and mashed. And I'm sure during my stay here I'm going to cover a lot of these recipes over here. So if you're interested, don't forget to give this video a like. And I hope you'll enjoy this exploration of Nazing Bazaar, which has just started. Oh, I'm just going to stop at every place. Look at this beautiful wild, flowers. So this beautiful flowers that you can see is actually eatable, and they are called alot in Garo language. We cook them by frying as well as with khalchi, or locally known as khar in Assam, and they are really yummy. So if you are interested to know these recipes, do let me know and drop in your comments. Also, along with it, she's selling this beautiful looking and really fresh drumstick flowers. I know drumsticks are pretty popular across India, but we really enjoy eating them with small fishes as well as dried fish. And I'm really sorry, the blossoms are already falling off here, so I'm just going to keep it down. By the way, I've taken permission from her to go ahead and touch her vegetables, although I'm not buying one. And these are also really popular and beautiful looking flowers. Abhi, ya ko mai mula?
Mula.
Mula.
Mula bival.
Mula bival.
Bival.
Yeah, these are called mula bival. I'm really ignorant about a lot of local names here, so pardon me for that. Yeah, there are too many tribes, so everyone calls it different. But I haven't tried these ones. I'm really excited. My kiss hunga ikho.
Haji bacha.
Haji bacha ya, jita ke bacha ya ikhode.
Haji.
Haji.
Okay, so she gave me some tips about the, you know, how to cook this vegetable, or I would rather say flowers. And these are so beautiful, isn't it? I could just give somebody as a gift on Valentine's Day, which is tomorrow, but unfortunately I won't. These are just vegetables. So these are the crockles. Yeah, you get them, you know, from the plains, and this is how we sell them in plastic bags. They are pretty delicious, and I'm looking forward to cooking them with pumpkin as well as some rice flour powder. That's how we eat. And these are locally known as ichaluk, also samuk, and it's very popular across Northeast India. We prepare in our own versions in every household. But if you are interested to try out these delicious crockles, do let me know what you think about, you know. And if you have any recipe of your tribe, don't forget to share it on my Gmail account, which is sigdasbioscope@gmail.com. I'll really look forward to that. I just couldn't resist from showing you guys how fresh this pudina patta, or what do you call, mint leaves looks like. They are just perfect soup for some mojito on this warm day. Yeah, it's just mid of Feb, but I must say it's already getting hot here, and you basically don't need a sweater. I just can't get over this line, which I was quite wise enough to choose. This is once you come down the road, you know, and there's a wall here. I guess this is somebody's residence through which you can definitely see. And most of the local producers produce are available here, so I'm really looking forward to this this patch whenever I come for shopping here. But before that, let me show you something.
Those are eel, guys, and not snakes. They taste like fish. Oh my god, they're quite slimy to look at, but they really taste awesome. We even dry them and store.
They are pretty available across Southeast Asia, and like I said, these are temporary shops, so they just come with those bags or local baskets that they make, which is here. Yeah, and they get their stuff, sell it, and go back home with whatever, and as well as purchase whatever they get. All right, guys, so I just stopped here to show you something really exotic. These are mecheng, also known as mejenga or whatever. You know, basically these are Sichuan pepper leaves, which are available. They're really sharp and goes so well with pork and as salads as well. We chop it into small pieces and, you know, toss it with some green vegetables, I would say. These are some of the lemons or limes that we get. Yeah, they look so juicy. They're pretty large, if you can see my palm. Yeah, so they are really juicy. And okay, I think I'm just blocking this way. Yeah, so they are really, beautiful to look at and tastes pretty delicious. If you have watched my previous video, I really enjoy eating with the skin. However, that is something that only if you want to, you can give it a try. It has a bitter taste just like orange or any other citrus fruit. If you are interested in these handmade baskets, this is where we carry our fruits and vegetables or rice. Climb down the hill, bring it down the valley and sell it, and then carry whatever you want to back to your home up in the hills. And these are tamarind. Yeah, if you're wondering what is that, that is some raw pepper corns, which is dried at home and sold out. And then you have again Indian gooseberry, ichalok or crockles. Thing why I do not prefer eating cabbage in South India is because they are not delicious, unlike what we get here. If you look at them, they are so fresh and juicy. As soon as you put them in your pan, the water just oozes out. I'm going to cover some of the recipes with local cabbages that you get here, and I'll keep moving. I hope you're enjoying watching this video. I have done a similar one of Rungram Bazaar, so don't forget to watch it out. I'll put it in the cards up here. And there are a lot of things to show you guys. I'm sure you must be overwhelmed by now by the number of vegetables and fruits that we get in this part of the country. And these are all tropical vegetables and fruits, just so you know. Just like any other Southeast Asian countries, you will see a similar variety, but a different, I would say a similar species, but a different, slightly different variety of each of these fruits and vegetables that you get. These are jamburas or maiyara. Jambura mo. Yeah, these are called pomelo in English and are quite popularly available throughout Southeast Asia. Yeah, they're quite huge, almost as size, and these are off season now, so they're quite ripe and juicy. If you look at the size, they grow pretty big. I must say, as big as football sometimes. And those are the beautiful sweet potatoes. Oh, I love sweet potatoes. I wish I had a bag, but today is not the day to shop, guys. I have a lot to cover and I cannot carry bags today since I'm alone. Those are the most popular brooms available throughout India. Yeah, 555 was one of the brand which is pretty popular in my household, I must say, outside Meghalaya. That's the only brand that we buy. And these are all grasses. The broomsticks, here we have to clean it ourselves, just so you know. And these are the vegetables and herbs that you will get around this time of the year. I hope you guys are amazed by the variety of fruits, vegetables and the herbs that you get. Look at those brinjals. They're really skinny and goes well with dried fish, also called nakham. Yeah, I'm just going to go.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay guys, so if you're wondering what are these, are loofah. Yeah, this once you peel the outer skin, these are also vegetable when raw. However, these are ripened and then dried on the tree, and this makes out into this most expensive loofahs that you will buy from a shopping mall costing about 200 rupees and plus. And if you're wondering what are these in these bottles, these are all alkaline solution made from a banana tree trunk after being burned and turned into ash known as kalchi. Yeah, there are different colors. I guess the decoctions are different, hence. Yeah, those bananas look so yummy. I wish I could carry it for my mother, but unfortunately I'll give it a skip for now. I hope my voice is audible, but they all are beautiful, amazing women. All right, so I'm going to take a different route now. And well, most of these people here are Bengalis, but they come from the plains of the state, and whatever you get it in the valley, not valley, I would say plains of Meghalaya, they come here and sell it. Yeah, they kind of produce vegetables which are pretty repetitive in nature and often consumed, like cabbages, broccoli. I would say pumpkins are not so popular, but yeah, chilies to tomatoes, carrots are basically what they produce. And anything that you get across India would be sold by, a similar vegetable will be sold by these folks. However, the exotic ones, you will get it only from the tribal folks living in the hills, is what I would say. Yeah, you have almost everything. You can see all the Indian spices that you can expect, and this is the way the tribal people from the hills were introduced to Indian spices. When people from the plains would come down and sell in these kind of hubs, we were introduced almost to everything about 100 years ago only, or even more for some of the older tribes living closer to the plains. But for people from the hills, I think we were introduced to most of the masalas only later. We do not have much traditional food wherein we add masalas, and this is the only reason why. So let's head further. Yeah, any kind of utensil that you would wish to buy, you can come here too. And like I said, I really love that plate. Yeah, these are so durable. And don't these plates remind you of social, guys? Yeah, some of you might not like it. So I'm not buying those plates. The only reason being, as I mentioned earlier, I wish I could. I really like that. Probably I'll come next Saturday with MJ or somebody to cover them. These are all plastic, and rest of the goods that you can expect. They look pretty fancy. I think I'm just not holding the camera in the right direction. Let me just flip it.
I want
I'm just gonna rest here for a couple of minutes and let me tell you guys, if you are into fashion and enjoy thrifting, this is one of the best places to be in. Are available here. They are not branded, just to let you know, but if you can mix and match and really enjoy, you know, dressing up, I would say you can come here and buy lot of clothes which are pretty cheap. I wouldn't say cheap, which are pretty, I mean, reasonably priced. You can see a lot of ladies around shopping. So this is one shop where I really wanted to stop and show you this beautiful and really colorful place, which are, you know, covered, which he has lined them up with the local sarongs that we get here in Garo Hills. So this patch is all about dried fish. You have like so many different types, and it's kind of stinky for most of you. However, in this kind of, you know, volume, it is stinky even for us. And if you look at this, it's a fermented dried fish which has been turned upside down from the box, and hence since it's gooey, it's completely intact. And these are smaller ones. Yeah, most of them are puthi. You have so many stores, so I'm sure you are going to get a good bargain. So do come here if you all love dried fish. There's so many types. I'm really overwhelmed. It's been ages since I visited a local market, and this really excites me. I hope I can just like, you know, pick all of them and take it back home, but unfortunately today is not the day to shop. Okay, the line goes on and on. I guess it's almost like about 300 meters of dried fish on both sides. These are sold mostly by the people from the plains, like I have mentioned, in exchange of, you know, goods and vegetables which were available in the hills. So if you are interested to explore some dry fish market, this is really good. And as any other fish market, this is pretty noisy as well. Oh my god, look at the heaps of dried fish. For many of you who are not into fish, this place is, or even, you know, even if you are a fishitarian, this place is going to be significantly stinky. And you have some of them, yeah, I know they're trying to sell, however I'm just gonna skip and show you what this market has to offer. There's so many types. I hope you're enjoying watching this video so far. It's going to be slightly longer than usual. I can't even stretch my hand because of the crowd. But definitely, this is always amazing to come to weekly market. And this is one of the most popular one, like I have mentioned earlier. So if you are in Tura, don't forget to visit Najing Bazaar on a Saturday morning to see what are locally available here during that season. This is one of the best time as well to come to market. Made out of bamboo, and we basically clean the rice. You can see this Ambi showing us how to use it, and she's testing it before she purchased one. Aren't they so pretty? And these are mats. All of them are hand woven. Oh my god, he just took all the torn currencies and taped them into with the cello tape. Yeah. It's quite saddening to not know that they could have exchanged this at the bank and got something, some cash instead of decorating. But this piece looks really nice. Yeah, and he's been selling some dried herbs. I believe these are like local medicines that you get. You have a lot of shoe repair shops here. Just get your chappals fixed and move on.
Yeah.
you are, guys. If you are a donut fan, this is the place to be in. Her store is filled with donuts. They're pretty popular, but they are not as soft. But we really like it slightly harder than what we get in those fancy mall shops. You have a lot of flowers. In case if you are interested, followed by some knives. If you are wondering what are these are piglets. You can they come here to sell so that you can take them home and rear it on your own. Yeah, look at these beautiful lovely ladies up here, and they are caged and they are oinking as well. Oh, look at them, they're so pretty. If you see those empty stores there, yeah, here, there were pork being sold out here, but it's gone. Yeah, you still have some there. Those are some traditional beads that you get. Yeah, these are all waste bands. In the olden times, they were made with a different material, which we do not get. So these are just a replica of them. The patterns are really beautiful and amazing looking. I like the simpler ones that you get there. These are all headgear that you tie like a scarf on your forehead. And those are the waistband again. The rest all are just knick and knacks, regular accessories that any women would enjoy. This is a furniture market. Yeah, these are all made locally by the people, and the finishing isn't great, but the wood quality seems to be good. You get sofas to beds to tables, racks. I really like this one, if I have to say. This looks good. You have benches, center tables. Yeah, again, sofas, like I said, the sofas looks really pretty, and I'm sure they are going to cost a bomb if you buy anywhere other than this place. So I've come to an end of another beautiful video of a bazaar in Northeast India. I hope you have enjoyed this video. So don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe.
Okay.
We just photo bombed. This has been quite funny. And if you see, the crowd has got significantly lean now. It's almost 11 o'clock. And I will see you soon in another vlog. So until then, bye guys. Stay safe and happy.